Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. I am Nightkid Zero, and today, obviously, my voice is still not cooperating. So, we are going to do an episode of Vampyr. Gameplay only. Luckily, the game has text, and the cutscenes have subtitles. So, if you want to click off the video, I totally get it. But, either way, thanks for coming by and checking it out. So, let's get into it. And you'll see me again. Hopefully my voice will be fixed.
Informing London's inhabitants of the presence of vampires. What does that make me? A double or a triple agent?
Go home. This one's mine! best be on your way home.
Done. Mr. Throgmorton should be happy.
Boots.
Good evening, Mr. Throgmorton.
Dr. Reid, can I be of any assistance? Have you noticed anything suspicious lately?
I put up your public service announcement. Consider the common folk warned about the vampiric presence.
Thank you, Dr. Reid. You may not realize it, but you saved a great many lives today.
Do you really think they could be useful?
See the sad saint of the East End? How a single man can help so many people? I consider myself the discreet protector of these men and women.
Have you heard any rumors regarding Sean Hampton's shelter?
I spent days observing the place, but the vampires still got in. Evil. It's everywhere, Dr. Reid.
Do you need my medical attention, sir?
Actually, I may. In my line of work, I have to stop at any sign of infection.
Treating a vampire hunter's wounds is certainly a first for me. I'm happy to help you, of course.
Thank you, Dr. Reid. Your support means a lot.
Never faced, let alone killed, a vampire, Ichabod. You're a fraud.
No, I'm not. I may embellish the truth concerning my achievements, but I'm totally dedicated to my quest.
Stop fooling yourself. You've never faced a vampire before. You wouldn't stand a chance.
Well, that's not true, sir. I've already faced one of these creatures.
Oh, really? And you're still alive.
Well, we did not actually fight. I let it go.
What do you mean?
I entered the vampire's den. The stench was terrible. I was ready to kill it. But then I saw it. Just a suffering soul like you and me. I spared her.
Tell me about the vampire. Spared.
She was a girl. Her body was a mess. I could see pus running from the deep wound. She was crying in pain.
You cared about her. That's what defines us as human, Ichabod.
Yes, but she was a truly evil creature. I'm haunted by the tragedies she caused ever since I spared her.
Goodbye, and good hunting, Mr. Throckmorton.
I can't protect the whole city. It's hard enough to cover the docks by myself.
Glad to see you again, Mr. Reid.
Goodbye, Miss Paxton. This could be the public house Giselle Paxton mentioned. We'll investigate. Giselle's stolen money. Prewin has some unethical ways of financing their war. It's locked.
Glad to see you again, Mr. Reid.
Lottie, tell me about the Wet Boot Boys. I know they've threatened you.
Edwina Cox wanted me to provide her with information about Mr. Hampton's resources. I refused.
Is that not dangerous?
Fuck them and their lies! They claim they protect the interests of the neighborhood, but they are just greedy parasites like all the rest.
I respect your courage, Miss Paxton, and I hope life will never wear you down.
Dr. Reid, you know how to make a girl blush. I am glad you came to the docks, whatever your real reasons are.
Do you have recent news of Sean Hampton's shelter?
That someone could be cruel enough to assassinate a saint. Maybe.
Goodbye, Miss Paxton.
Glad to see you again, Mr. Reid.
Do you need my medical attention, Miss Paxton?
I can keep going, Dr. Reid.
Of course you can, Miss Paxton. But I wouldn't recommend it. Please, take this. You will feel better.
Thank you, Dr. Reid. Thank you. Really.
Goodbye, Miss Paxton.
You again? What do you want?
I've identified the men who stole from you. You were right. They were members of some self-proclaimed militia.
I knew it! Did you find the money, too?
Yes. Here it is. They thought they could finance their activities with it.
I never thought a man like you would be kind enough to... I misjudged you. Badly. Well, thank you, sir.
Will you give the money back to your comrades, then?
Fuck those bastards who fired me. I'll give the money to Miss Gillingham. Her son Jack was a friend of mine. He was killed recently.
I know you were friends with Miss Gillingham's son, Jack. Tell me about his death.
Jack's murder has been a shock to the neighborhood. A sign that the situation is now out of control.
Why is that?
There has always been tension between the Wet Boot Boys and members of the trade union. But a murder? That's a first.
Who killed him?
No one will ever know. One thing is certain. While Jack was alive, I had one less reason to drink.
Why does that upset you so much?
I wish I had found the time and words to tell him how important he was to me before it was too late. Another failure for Giselle Paxton.
Well, I'll leave you for now. Goodbye, Miss Paxton. You must prepare, child, for the earth is bleeding and the harvest is upon us.
Stay away, whoever you are!
This is no time for petty quarrels, my champion. Can you not hear? The famished queen has awoken.
I am not your champion.
But of course you are, son. As surely as you are the blood of my blood.
I had to kill Mary.
I have known your pain, child. Do not succumb to it.
Silence! I dismiss you now!
The land calls for a champion. All and everyone needs you.
Silence! I'm tired of all these puppet shows.
This is my territory!
Good evening, sir. It's me again.
Leave me alone, I say, whoever you are.
It cannot be safe for a blind man to live here alone. Let me enter, sir. I swear I mean you no harm.
Well, a voice never lies, and yours clearly is the voice of a gentleman. All right, Doctor, come on in.
What kind of gentleman pays visits to people at this late hour?
So what is the name of my nocturnal visitor?
I'm Dr. Jonathan Reid. As I already explained to you, I'm inquiring about the epidemic.
Dr. Reid? The eminent surgeon? My God! I'd never have expected a brilliant physician like you to knock on my door.
You flatter me, sir.
No, sir, I am flattered. I read all your work when I still had my sight. I loved it. I'm Mason Swanborough, by the way.
Do you know Braille, Mr. Swanborough?
I'm no expert, but I learned it in my spare time, yes. Why?
I found a strange document entitled Cure for Blindness. It's written in Braille, so I thought perhaps it was yours.
Really? Is that some kind of sick joke? Let me see.
Here it is.
This letter seems authentic. And it actually refers to an experimental cure for blindness. You have piqued my interest, Dr. Reid.
Could it be of any use to you?
No. This page is just a part of a larger diary. I'd be glad if you could find the other pages.
You seem unwell, sir. Do you need my assistance?
Actually, I feel worse than usual. Can you give me something?
Yes. I can give you a little something that has been proven effective.
Thank you, Doctor.
How is the sanitary situation evolving in Whitechapel these days?
I hear them hissing and scratching at my door every night. The sick made mad by the fever. But these walls are thick, and my lock is solid.
Does someone take care of you in this isolated place?
My sister Loretta and I have our daily routine. Every morning and evening she comes by so we can talk and eat. Then she leaves and I stay.
Where does your sister go?
Well, let's just say, she earns enough money for us both.
What's so amusing about that?
I won't hide the truth from you. Loretta sells a fake miracle elixir to the sick people of Whitechapel.
Do you not appreciate your sister's visits?
Loretta is the best and worst thing that happened to me. And I believe she could say the same thing about me.
And what else have you learned about me, Mr. Swanborough?
I know you assisted Professor Carell in France, and that you invented a new blood transfusion method based on his work.
Yes. Those were frustrating but exciting days. I loved it.
Yes, the thrill of research and discovery. This is what drives people like us, Dr. Reid. Oh, how I envy you.
Goodbye, Mr. Swanborough. I'll leave you now.
Tell me, how do you see the world these days?
What kind of gentleman pays visits to people at this time?
It's locked.
Let's pin it down!
Doctor, can I help you?
Do you need assistance?
That would be nice of you, Doctor. Who knows what I may have caught during my investigation?
If you persist in investigating the most pox-ridden boroughs of London, you must accept the risks.
Thank you, sir.
How are conditions in Whitechapel at the moment?
I always thought it was my...
And you're not sure...
Empty...
Goodbye, Mr... Good evening, Mr. Whittaker.
It's Father Whittaker, my son. So, are you still lost in your rational delusions?
Don't you fear getting sick yourself?
Faith gives me all I need, my son. If I must fall, then so be it.
No doubt your faith will prevail, but let me give you some extra protection against the devil's work. Medicine.
Blessed be your generosity, my son.
I have had enough for tonight. Goodbye. Good evening, Mr. Nithercott.
And good evening to you too, my good sir. Can I be of any help?
Do you need medical attention, sir?
It may be wise to let you prescribe me something. I don't feel like I should.
I understand your appetite for words and macabre beauty, sir. But you should be more careful.
The nutrition of my mind is more important than my physical health. But I appreciate your concern, sir.
I'll leave you alone, sir.
You again? What do you want this time?
How is the sanitary?
I'm not easy.
Can I offer you my medical expertise, Mr. Peterson?
Keep your medicines for others.
There is a thin line between pride and stupidity, sir. Please take this medication. You'll feel better.
All right. I'll take it then. It's not like I don't appreciate the gesture.
Goodbye, Mr. Peterson.
Fancy buying something, sir?
You never lose your focus, do you? Right then. Show me what you have.
fancy buying something, sir?
You never lose your focus, do you? Do you need help, sir?
To be honest, I'd prefer you take a look at my stuff. I'd rather be rich and sick than the contrary.
I will see you later. Goodbye for now, Mr. Lewis.
To bother, Mr. Doctor.
How do you feel, Mr. Petrescu? Do you need my help?
I would not even accept fresh water from you, Doctor. I don't need your help.
Yes, you do. Please, take this. You'll feel better.
I said I don't want anything. But I'll keep this for those who really need it.
Goodbye, Mr. Petrescu. Good evening, Zhaoshu.
Wang Shanghao, Dr. Reid. It's good to see you again.
How do you feel? Physically speaking, I mean.
I don't feel good, Dr. Reid. Not at all.
I will see you later. Goodbye for now.
It's locked.